Hello, I'm Dr. Sanjay Panicker. I founded Amrita Homeopathy. We are placed at two locations in Bangalore, one at Koramangala, the other at Marathali. Anemia is a reduction in the amount of hemoglobin in the blood, leading to reduction in oxygen flow to the tissues. A value of less than 12 in women and less than 14% in men is considered to be as anemia. Anemia is of basically three types. One is whenever there's a reduction in the production of red blood cells, they call erythrocytes. When there's a reduction in the erythrocyte production, or when there is a damage of the existing erythrocytes in the blood, that's red erythrocytes or red blood cells, when there's a destruction of them in the blood, or when there is a blood loss leading to loss of the blood cells, these three factors can cause anemia. Now, if you look at the factor of decreased production, why should the body reduce its production of blood cells? As you know, red blood cells carry the oxygen to the tissues. Now, when their number is lesser, the oxygenation of the tissues will reduce and symptoms are produced according to that. When there is a deficiency of certain nutrients that is required, like B12, folic acid, iron, or proteins in the diet that we consume, there can lead to a reduction in the production of red blood cells. Also, we do see that blood cells can be reduced when there is defect in the combination of intrinsic factor and B12. This intrinsic factor is produced by certain cells in your gastric mucosa called as parietal cells. These cells are supposed to produce intrinsic factor, but due to some autoimmune damage in certain conditions like pernicious anemia, the intrinsic factor is not produced. And so it cannot combine with B12. And so the absorption of B12 doesn't happen. Even though you take a good nutrition, the absorption may not happen because B12 is not combining with intrinsic factor. The third factor which leads to anemia is blood loss. Blood loss can be acute or it can also be chronic. In acute blood loss, it is basically because of injury. In chronic blood loss, it can be because of some conditions involving the gastrointestinal tract, where there is a GI bleeding, or it can be hemorrhoids, or it can be some conditions inside the abdomen like cancers, where there is a chronic bleeding that is happening, which can lead to anemia. Even worm infestations can be one of the causes which can lead to anemia. Again, any diseases where there's an inflammation involved in the body, like in kidney diseases or in chronic cancers, there can be deficiency in absorption of the nutrition. And so it can lead to reduced RBC production. In chronic kidney disease, erythropoietin, which is supposed to be produced in the kidney, is not produced, and that can also lead to anemia. The factor which contributes to anemia is breakdown of the blood cells which is already there in your body. This can happen due to genetic factors, or it can also be acquired. Acquired is like, let us say, certain medicines can cause destruction of the red blood cells. Certain diseases can cause destruction of blood cells, like malaria, falciparum malaria can cause destruction of blood cells. Certain toxins can cause destruction of the blood cells. Other than that, the genetic factors which can be seen very commonly is sickle cell anemia, thalassemia, and spherocytosis. Even 6-GPD disease can also cause deficiency, and so there can be a destruction of the blood cells, and then hemoglobin can go down. The treatment of anemia with homeopathy involves various medicines which will improve the root cause of the problem. So in hemolytic anemia, there are some medicines made out of snake venom also, which can help to clear the conditions where the hemoglobin is low. There are also other medicines like ferrum fos and ferrum met, which helps to increase the production of red blood cells. In bloodletting, where the blood is lost, then maybe in severe cases, there may be requirement of blood transfusion. But if it's a mild case where there's only a deficiency of the hemoglobin or reduction in the blood cells, then maybe even supplementation with medicines like ferrum fos can build back the hemoglobin.